There's been a huge amount of conjecture and discussion in the media after the recent Stanford incident in Antigua. The ECB obviously have now terminated all contracts with Alan Stanford, and Giles Clarke, who's come under a little bit of fire recently, spoke today to ECBtv.
I know there's been a lot of other debate and there's been a lot of other comment. That goes with this particular job. There's nothing new about that. What I would say is that for my predecessors, Zimbabwe was the issue which haunted them, which the media were focused in on, which they grappled with difficulty. I don't criticise them for it, it's just true. I was determined when I became chairman that Zimbabwe would not be an issue that did the same to me. And if you think that we would have been, in inverted commas, welcoming Zimbabwe to England in April, had we not taken action at the end of June last year at the ICC. And they're not coming. And we've dealt with that issue in the same way that we will deal with the other difficult issues that we have to face. We played a game of cricket which we'd contracted to play, for which we were paid. We did so in good faith. We did so because we wanted to raise funds for the benefit of the game in England and Wales. We transferred those funds for the benefit of England, the game in England and Wales. And I've been very interested to be told by one of the journalists who's been interviewing me today that he has actually got personal experience of those funds arriving at his cricket club. So that was why we did it. We believed we were doing something that would have benefit for both our players and for the game. We are not a financial regulatory authority. We cannot be expected to do the job that they do. And they, after all, have only just determined that there were major issues on Stanford. It is their job to protect depositors and investors, and they've only recently determined that that was something that needed to be done with regard to the Stanford organisation. We did something, a transaction for which we carried out our side of the contract and for which we were paid. We've used those monies for the benefit of cricket and England and Wales. I think there's much debate, legitimately, about the national team itself under that name participating in those types of games. We've been approached by very large numbers of entrepreneurs, many with no history in cricket, and Stanford had a significant history of sponsoring cricket in these islands. Those people haven't. I think it's an important area. And what I've said to a number of your colleagues, is we will clearly need to look and use our independent advisors on our audit committee. I've spoken to the Secretary of State's office since this has taken place to say that we want to sit down and talk to them about how sport, because all sports have been affected by this who were involved, golf and indeed footballers, tennis players, even the royal family playing polo. So sport needs to see what do we do in this changing age, this time of great turbulence financially and economically, how do we evaluate who should sponsor us? We've had a history after all in cricket of a degree of, we stayed with tobacco for a lot longer than most did, and we need to do that. And I've had some good dialogue with the Secretary of State's office. We've talked about it as a board. We'll be looking at what we need to do to ensure that our independent advice is robust in these areas. The SEC, who are the regulatory body who are in charge, took action in February 2009. The SEC have far more resources than any body or any entity could possibly cover, and yet they had not closed him down or not accused him of acts which are yet to be tried until then. And our job as sports administrators is to seek to look after the grassroots of the game in particular. To do that, we have to raise money. You cannot have a sport without having money. Now, there are elements of how, who is providing that money, which clearly, as I've said, we're going to look at the structures and how we take those forward.